Bhindi is one vegetable which is mostly loved by everyone. I make a variety of dishes using bhindi, and today I'm going to make a really crispy and delicious Kurkuri Bhindi recipe for you all. In this recipe, bhindi is first coated with masala and then it is deep fried until it is crispy and crunchy. You can either serve it as an appetizer or even as a side dish for your main course. So come, let's waste no time and see how to make this recipe. We'll start by preparing our bhindi. I have washed the bhindi very well, wiped it clean with a kitchen towel, and then I have cut them into thin long pieces. So basically one bhindi, you just slit it into half, and then those halves you again slit it into another halves. So like that I have prepared all the bhindi. I have 250 grams of it here. Now we'll add this bhindi into a bigger bowl. Also make sure to remove as many seeds from this bhindi as possible, because while frying those seeds get burned and do not give a very tasty feel to a dish. We'll add salt. Red chilli powder. Turmeric powder. Garam masala powder, roasted cumin powder, and some chaat masala. Mix everything well and we'll let this bhindi rest for 10 minutes. What will happen is, because we have added salt to it, it will release all the water that it has, and that will help bind the besan that we will be adding to our bhindi later. Make sure to rest the bhindi for 10 minutes because this step is very, very important. Bhindi has released some water now and the masala has kind of stuck to it. And now we'll add besan. And cornflour. Just toss it well with the bhindi and now we'll fry it. I've heated some oil here and now we'll fry our bhindi in this oil, but make sure to fry it in batches. If you'll put all the bhindi together, it'll start to release steam and it'll not get crispy. So for this amount of bhindi, we'll try to fry in 3 batches. So the oil is not too hot, you want it fairly hot enough. Now increase the heat and you want to fry your bhindi on a very high heat. Now while frying the bhindi, you have to be very careful. You don't want to burn the bhindi, but you also don't want it raw. So it should be nice and crisp, but there's a very, very fine line between getting it crisp and burning. So you have to keep an eye on it throughout and keep stirring it while you are frying. Our bhindi is fried now. You can see it has turned out little brown but not burned, and now we'll take it out. You can also to test it if the bhindi is fried properly, you can take one piece out, just check between your fingers if it is crunchy, and if it is, then you can take it out. Drain the bhindi on a tissue lined plate like how I am doing, so that it absorbs all the extra oil that bhindi has, and the bhindi will still keep its crunch. Now fry the remaining bhindi similarly in another 2 batches, and yes, that's it. So I have fried all the bhindi and see how crisp it is. Lastly, we'll just squeeze some lemon juice on top, and this bhindi is ready to serve. You can either serve it as an appetizer or even with your main course. Here we go. hope you all like this recipe, and if you did, do not forget to like, share and subscribe to my YouTube channel. If you have any questions, leave me a comment below and I'll definitely try to revert back. See you all very soon with a new recipe. Till then, bye-bye.